In this video, I'll demonstrate how to implement JWT authentication in an ASP.NET Core Web API. We'll also discuss password hashing and its importance. JWT authentication involves creating a token that clients can use to verify their identity. Let's get started. First, let's install the microsoft.asp.net core.authentication.jwt bearer library, which is required for JWT implementation. Now, let's open App Settings and create a configuration section named JWT config. First, specify the issuer, which identifies who created and signed the token, allowing the recipient to verify its authenticity and integrity. You can use the application URL here. Next, define the audience, which ensures the token is sent to the correct recipients. Use the same URL here. Then, provide a strong secret key used to generate the token's signature. Finally, set the token validity duration in minutes. Now, let's add the necessary dependency services. First, we'll configure authentication by setting the default authentication scheme, default challenge scheme, and default scheme to JWT bearer defaults.authentication scheme. We'll use the addJWTBearer method and configure some options. For testing purposes, I'll disable require HTTPS metadata, but I recommend enabling it in production to ensure HTTPS is required for metadata. I'll also enable save token. Next, we'll configure the token validation parameters. We'll read the issuer and audience from app settings and assign them to valid issuer and valid audience. Then, we'll assign the signing key and enable the required validations. We'll also add the authorization service. Finally, ensure you have added the middlewares for authentication and authorization. Now, let's create a folder to store the API request and response model classes. First, I'll create the login request model class with properties for username and password. Next, we'll create the login response model class, which includes the authenticated username, access token, and the token's expiry time in seconds. Before continuing, I want to mention that this source code is available on our Patreon page for you to download and reference. Next, let's create a folder named service and add a service to generate the JWT token. In the class constructor, we'll receive the DB context and configuration dependencies. I'm not going into detail about DB context and other database operations, as the source code is available on Patreon for your reference. We'll assign these dependencies to private read-only objects. Now, I'll create a method that accepts a login request object as a parameter and returns a login response object after generating the token. First, we'll verify if the username or password is empty or null, and return null if they are. If both are valid, we'll fetch the user account by filtering with the username. If the user account doesn't exist or the password is invalid, we'll return null. We'll verify the hashed password using a handler class named passwordHashHandler, which includes a method for hashing passwords and another one for verifying them during login. Saving hashed passwords in the database protects against unauthorized access and ensures security. I have previously shared a Patreon exclusive sample project, and I'll use the same code here. Next, we'll read the issuer, audience, key, and the token validity from app settings. We can add the validity minutes to the current time to get the exact expiry timestamp. Then, we'll create the token descriptor object. In the subject property, you can add all the necessary claims. I'll currently add only the username. We'll assign other properties along with signing credentials. Now, we'll generate the token using the JWT security token handler object and store it in a variable named access token. Finally, we'll return a new login response object with the access token, username, and the total seconds for token expiry. Now, let's create a new controller for user authentication. We already have a user account controller in this project to manage user accounts, create, read, update, and delete. In this class constructor, we'll inject the JWT service and assign it to a private read-only object. To do this, we need to add it as a dependency. I'll simplify this to an inline method. Let's create the API method for login. We'll use the authenticate method to return a login response object. If the login response is null, we'll return an unauthorized response. Otherwise, we'll return the result. We'll make this method accessible to anonymous users and set the method type to HTTP post. Next, let's move to the user account controller and add the authorize attribute to ensure these CRUD methods can only be called by authorized users. In the DB context, we'll seed a single user with the name administrator to allow authorization for creating other user accounts. I'll add the migration and update the database. In our database, we can see the created user with the hashed password saved. Let's test our application now. In Swagger, we can see all the methods. Swagger allows us to authorize by saving the token. I'll show you how to do that shortly. First, let's try to log in. Using an invalid password results in an unauthorized response. Now, let's try with valid credentials. We received the login response, which includes the username, access token, and the token's expiry time in seconds. Next, let's try to execute the get method to fetch all users. We are receiving an unauthorized response, so let's enable authorization in Swagger. In the program class, we can see the added dependency service for Swagger. Let's configure some options. First, create an object of OpenAPI security scheme and assign the necessary properties. Then, add the security definition and security requirement using this object. In Swagger, we can now see an authorize button that prompts for the JWT access token. First, we'll execute the login method to get the access token. Provide the received token and click authorize button. We are now logged in. If you call the get method again, you should see the data. Let's try creating a new user account. We received a success response and the newly created user appears in the database. That's it for this video. Don't forget to check out our Patreon page. You can find the URL in the video description. Support us by joining Patreon, where members gain access to source codes, early access, and other exclusive content. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.